So what Rutherford proposed was that the atom, in fact, is largely negatively charged. And when the atom is negatively charged, the alpha particles in most cases go straight through with tiny deflections because they are being pushed and pulled by the negative charge because of Coulombic interaction. Most of the alpha particles went straight through with little or no deflection. So this angular deviation was very small, about 1 degree. But at the center of this atom, there was a small mass, a concentrated mass of positive charge. And the positive charge is so large that it balances all the negative charge inside the volume. Therefore, it must be very dense. It must be in a small volume and a high positive charge. And a charge high enough to balance all the negative charge. But all of it is in the center. So that when occasionally an alpha particle sees this central part head on, an occasional alpha particle that sees this central mass head on, it is repelled by this strongly positive center and is deflected at large angles. And if one gets the condition right, that is, the statistics dictates that once in a while, an alpha particle comes in and makes a head-on collision with the central part, it can be deflected backward through an angle of 180 degrees. So the key is that when this experiment was performed over a long period of time, over days and days, and a large number of observations were made, some of those alpha particles would seem to be deflecting through very large angles, much different from zero, approaching 180 degrees. So the major conclusion that Rutherford made is that the atom is largely negatively charged, it has a large volume, but inside the atom, there is a positively charged center which is extremely dense. It has a high charge, a high positive charge, a very small volume, and this positive charge was responsible for scattering the alpha particles through a large angle. This central part was called the nucleus.